So welcome you all for the Pro Pharma channel, and we started with NMR series and completed with part 1 where I introduced and the principle of NMR, and we talked about spinning nuclei, precisional frequency. Now we come to the part 2 of NMR. I request if those who have not seen, they can see the Pro Pharma channel part 1 and come to part 2. In part 2 we are going to talk about the energy transitions, relaxations and the concept of chemical shift. So we said that a spinning nuclei kept under the external magnetic field has a precisional frequency, and it can assume two orientations depending upon the spin quantum number of a particular proton. So when I talk about a proton spin quantum number, it is half. So 2i plus 1 becomes 2. So proton can assume either an aligned orientation or an opposed orientation with respect to the external magnetic field. So when an aligned proton can absorbs energy, it can go to the opposed state, that is higher energy state. Aligned proton is always a lower energy proton and opposed proton is always a higher energy proton. So when an aligned energy proton gains energy, it can go to opposed state, and when opposed energy proton loses energy, it can come to the aligned state. So the transition of one state to another is called as flipping. So my protons are continuously in the mode of flipping. These are called as energy transitions. If a precising nuclei is irradiated with a beam of correct radio frequency, then only the flipping occurs. So whenever the precisional nuclei, that is a nuclei spinning present under the external magnetic field, is precising and the precisional frequency matches with the radio frequency which is coming in, then a resonance takes place and then only an absorption takes place, which leads to flipping. So a proton will absorb energy from an RF source only if the precisional frequency of a proton is same as the frequency of RF beam. So when they both match, then only a resonance occurs, and this resonance which is occurring is between the nuclei and RF beam, and hence it is called as nuclear magnetic resonance. So this is all about energy transition and the word meaning of the word resonance. Coming to relaxation processes, I have two types of relaxation: spin lattice relaxation and spin relaxation. What does this mean? This is all again related to energy, that nuclei are having some either aligned or opposed. They are at a lower energy level or a higher energy level. But when there is a transfer of energy from the excited nuclei or protons to the molecular lattice. What is molecular lattice? These are surrounding new solvent molecules. Then that is called as spin lattice relaxation. That is, the energy of the spin is transferred to the lattice, that is the solvent molecules or molecular lattice surrounding it. So as the nuclei is continuously surrounded by the lot of neighboring molecules, either of the same molecule or the solvent molecule, a spin lattice relaxation, which is a T1 process, involves has total energy which is not getting affected, which means when I consider entire system, then some energy which is transferred from protons goes to the solvent, but it is still in the system, which means the total energy of the system is not affected. So it is important to note here, total energy is not affected. Next type of relaxation is spin relaxation. Here there is a mutual exchange of the spin. What is mutual exchange? As I said, one is in the opposed state and one is in the aligned. So more opposed thing nuclei, which is at higher energy, gives energy to the aligned nuclei, which is at lower energy. And because of this transfer, opposed nuclei comes to aligned state, whereas the other aligned neighboring aligned proton goes to an opposed state. So there is a mutual exchange of spin energy. One nuclei loses energy and the other gains energy, and hence no net change in the population energy state is seen. So these are the two types of relaxation: spin lattice and spin, also called as T1 and T2. So coming to a very important concept called as chemical shift. Till now we were talking about only nuclei or a spinning nuclei or its precisional frequency interacting with RF source, giving me some kind of information which helps me in structural elucidation. But every proton or any proton, if absorb same energy, then it cannot give me different information, and I am not able to determine the structure. So what is the basis on which the NMR is able to elucidate a structure is, every proton which we are talking about is always present in a different electronic environment. The neighbors besides these protons are always different, and that govern the chemical shift or the signal where exactly the proton is going to come. So in NMR, the NMR spectrum is a plot of radio frequency versus the absorption, and the frequency of this signal is known as chemical shift, which is given by delta. And as I said, chemical shift indicates the electronic environment of the nucleus. So what is this chemical shift? A difference of the absorption position of a particular proton, a proton which I am considering, to the absorption position of a reference proton. So what is this reference proton? Some kind of a reference which we compare our proton with is called as a reference proton. And this delta values or chemical shift values are expressed in parts per million. They are measured in parts per million. So protons with same chemical shift, that is having same electronic environment around them, are called as equivalent protons, whereas those which are present in different chemical environment, they are non-equivalent protons. So because protons give us the information, the solvents which are used in NMR cannot have protons in them, and hence the solvents used in NMR are D2O, CdCl3, CCl4, etc. Chemical shift is expressing the difference in the absorption position of a particular proton with respect to reference, and this reference is TMS. So what is exactly TMS? It is an acceptable reference standard, tetramethylsilane. If you see, silica is attached to 4 methyl molecules. So I have in total 12 protons, and all the 12 protons are in the same chemical environment, and hence we say they are magnetically equivalent. And as they are magnetically equivalent, they show a single intense, a sharp absorption peak at 0 ppm. And hence they are considered to be reference standard. So at 0 ppm, they show me an intense peak. Other than that, TMS, when mixed with my sample, is easily miscible. Secondly, it can be easily removed because it has high volatility and low boiling point. Thirdly, it do not forms any kind of intermolecular association with the sample. So because of all these reasons, TMS is considered as an acceptable reference standard. Other than TMS, DSS can also be used as a reference standard for water-soluble compounds. The DSS is dimethyl silopentane sulfonic acid, where one of the CH3s of tetramethylsilane is replaced by sulfonic acid, pentane sulfonic acid. So these are the two reference standards which are used in NMR. So when we talk about chemical shift, it is a delta value given in ppm, which is the shift downfield from TMS, which is given in hertz, divided by what is the RF frequency of the spectrophotometer, which is given in millihertz. So that gives me a calculation of delta. So whenever I say a delta scale, it is always from 0 to 10 ppm. 0, I have a big sharp peak of TMS, that is a reference standard, and all the other protons are in different positions of delta with respect to that of TMS. So those are near to TMS are always of lower frequency protons, which are upfield, whereas those which are away from TMS are higher frequency and downfield. So this we have to keep in mind, that those protons which come near TMS are coming upfield and are of lower frequency, and the ones which are down, they are higher frequency and are downfield. However, what is exactly shielding and deshielding, we are going to see in the next video, that is part 3 of NMR. So stay tuned to ProPharma channel and keep watching the NMR series. Thank you for watching this video.